Waxed your legs first.
Okay, but if I roll it, how do I get it? Because I just find that I can't get it off on the right way.
I think that is just really sexy.
Really?
I think Minnie's right.
You're on there. Christ, that always happens when we're live. Kerry, we've got to get going. We've got the show to do. Roll titles.
Kelly Brook. She's been giving me lots of advice as her new film is all about school for seduction. It's going to hit the big screens very soon. I'm sure she'll be able to tell me where exactly. See, that's how you're supposed to do it.
See, yeah.
See, it's so simple when she does it. Maybe the hair was causing the problem.
Do you reckon? Yeah, and gorgeous Kelly Brook and Minnie Driver will both be in the studio and we'll be talking sex and singing.
Her dream partner. The look your heart can't disguise.
Everyone, okay. Remember, slowly.
I love this. Kelly, it's so nice to see you. Thank you so much for coming in.
Nice to see you again. I've seen you for ages.
Yeah, well, Kelly and I used to work together.
We did. Yeah, I know. You were saying he said very nice things about you. Very, 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 very nice things about you, indeed.
I hope so.
I don't think the things you would say about me were quite as nice. I don't know.
Oh.
No, I don't know. You're right.
Love the film. The film was fantastic. And I mean, not that you're not, but your character is so sexy in this film.
Yeah, that was the idea, and she's the teacher of the seduction classes. But, yeah, we based her on, like, modern-day Sophia Loren. And so I had to do the accent, and I got given a fabulous wardrobe by Celine. And it was just fun. It was just a great role.
But your accent, your Italian accent, was so... I was just sitting there looking, and I was going, this isn't the girl I know from Kent. This isn't the same girl that I work with on MTV. And there you are being this seductive Italian seductress.
I know, that was the fun of it. I really got to play a proper character and really, you know, get into it. And it was difficult, you know. I had to just, like, work with a voice coach and watch, like, Anna Magnani movies and just really, you know, spend the time to get my head around the accent.
Abby stood there, get your stockings off, lover.
That's how it works in your house.
Yeah,
that's how I started, but I got there in the end.
And how did you go about? Did you just find yourself sitting, talking to your boyfriend, talking to your friends, and testing out your
Italian? Yeah, like in the car, I'd just have the tapes in, and I would just keep doing it, and my girlfriends would help me, and it was just fun learning it, really.
I bet it was. And it's called School for Seduction. Yeah. So tell me, your new boyfriend, Billy Zane, did you do the seducing or did he do the seducing?
I don't know, both, I suppose.
Come on, what was the technique?
I think, like what the film says, it's just about being confident and just being yourself and not really, you know, just embracing all your flaws and not being embarrassed by them. That's what it's about.
And that's what you managed to do with Billy. Now, so there's one or two things that we need to embrace right now. Can I just have a look at this? Can I have a look at your ring?
Oh, you're
Can
so
I have a
cheeky.
Look at your ring? Can I have a look?
No!
Let's have a look!
No.
Let's have a look. It's massive. Now, did you come with the ring or did the ring come with you?
I think Billy actually got that from Titanic, didn't he? See the size of that thing?
That is beautiful.
He stole it.
Is that an engagement ring, Kelly?
Might be.
Really? Congratulations. That's so exciting.
Don't do it.
Oh, no, you were saying that in the green room.
I'm only joking.
Oh, you love your man still, I'm sure.
No. So, Kelly, anyway, carry on, babe. We're listening to you.
Have you set a date?
No.
You haven't set a date yet?
No.
But do you think you'll do it over here or is it in America?
I don't know if I'm going to get married.
You don't know if you're getting
married?
You just said it was an engagement ring.
No, I didn't. You said that.
Yeah. I'm sure you suggested it was. You seem to be splitting your time between LA and the UK now. Are you sort of enjoying it living over there?
Yeah, I love it. I love the lifestyle. You know, it's like my second home now, but I do miss England and I love coming home and I'm going out tonight with all my girlfriends from Rochester, so I'm looking forward to that. It's great being back and it's lovely to have a great film to promote because people seem to really like it, so...
I mean, it's the same, because you've just made your film as well, and it's interesting, isn't it, because suddenly you sort of get known in one sort of area of life and then you try and break out. To suddenly finally have a big vehicle that is you in a leading role in the film must be a bit of a relief as well, because people are finally going, well, you know Kelly's been out there for ages and here's the film.
Well, I've been out there working on like independent films and TV shows, but none of it kind of came here apart from Smallville. So when I read the script, I was like, at last, something, you know, worth coming home for. And it was, I knew people were going to like it and I had a feeling like people would enjoy it and it was going to get released. So it was a great opportunity. And
now, there's a great scene in this film, Kerry, that you'll love, right?
Okay.
Where basically Kelly gets her students and teaches them how to be seductive with some everyday items.
Well, I need this. I need this.
So I brought in some everyday items that I thought you could help us with. There's a watering can, and I brought in a toilet brush, I think, or is it a loofah?
No, it's not a toilet brush.
Okay,
so just if I've got a broom, what's the art of being seductive with an everyday item?
I think it's just to do things in a slow, sensual way.
So imagine you're...
I think you need to stand up and give like a... You need to kind of show you... No, I think you need to kind of hold the broom steady and then just work your way down the broom.
No, it's like you're just about to get the toilet, though.
Something like that.
I feel like
you don't
I'm
need
doing
to
Mary
try
Poppins.
Too
I'm
hard,
one of the
Ben.
Chimney sweeps. Hello. Hey, yeah.
You're sexy enough, you don't need to try that hard.
Oh, see, that's a very nice thing to say. We watching can. That's a bit Les Dawson. I think we should leave
we'll
the seductive,
yeah.
I think this would be a good time.
I think I need to get this film.
I think this would be a good time to bring in
to bring in
the gorgeous Mini Driver. I'm not sure if she's brought in an everyday item to be seductive with.
Look, a little transmitter.
Yeah, little mic.
You're dead sexy, that.
Well, it can be. Kelly can make it sexy.
No, I don't think even the gorgeous Kelly couldn't make that sexy.
It's lovely to see you. Thank you so much for coming in. Like Kelly's character, your character is a glamorous Italian, but glamorous in a very different way to Kelly's.
Oh, she's a horrible cow.
Should we have a quick before we?
She's not like Kelly. She's not like Kelly at all.
Should we have a quick look at your character in action?
These things do happen.
For the past 3 years, these things do happen, and did you stop them from happening? No. And you too. You are as bad as him. These things do happen, ma. And did you stop these things from happening? This thing does not happen. Orlando, andiamo! Bring my doggy and my foxy.
Amateurs.
You must have had such a laugh.
It was very fun.
It's sort of every day you're going on to set and you're sort of sat there and you're going, crikey, she's really over the top. But were you allowed to go as mad as you like?
Yeah, it was actively encouraged, actually. The director, Joel Schumacher, he said... when I was a bit worried about being over the top, he was like, honey, nobody ever paid to see under the top. But that was his big,
I think Simon Cowell has once or twice, but that's a whole different story. But look, that outfit as well, it's quite a lot of cleavage there.
Yes.
And that was, it's more cleavage than the weekend in Blackpool.
You can't tell.
I know, well, exactly. lucky old
Gary. Ben,
I was I was reading in the notes that Jennifer Ellison reckons that you sort of needed a little bit of help.
I had a corset on, which definitely
sort of all
pushed it all together. I tried using those funny chicken fillets. Yeah, cheers. Thanks for bringing it up because it's really nice that people have to talk about this.
They want to know.
Those funny
They're not even
that,
filming this minute.
This is not about. This has nothing to do with you. You know those funny chicken fillet things that give you to pad your bra sometimes. They're so disgusting and like cold dead flesh. I couldn't use them, so they just pull the corset in even tighter, and that generally does the trick.
And that's how it works.
You'll never know.
I know, I won't.
But
believe me, I'm
going
to have fun imagining it, which is one of the most important things. But I think sort of your last time we met up, Minnie, I was giving you a few pointers on playing the guitar. It was a lovely day actually. I enjoyed it immensely, and it clearly worked because the first thing we great. The new single's coming out in January.
What happened?
Yes, all thanks to you.
I know. And you're going on tour.
Going on tour in February, 3rd to the 10th, all around Glasgow, Manchester, Wolverhampton, London, all over.
Do you feel, are you sort of, we talked at the time about how great it was that you can finally sort of do your music, because it's something people sort of just assume that you're just this actress, but actually your music's been a big part of your life ever since you started acting, isn't it?
Yeah, I was a musician. Well, I was a musician sort of at the same time. I was signed to Island Records when I was 19 in a band, and what's in front of you, and films started happening for me, so that's the line that I went to. But I've always played music, I've just never done it publicly.
And obviously
definitely is. It was really hard to begin with, and now it's fun, it's good, it's good standing up there and just being yourself, or singing songs that I've written. I like that much more than singing other people's songs.
Because think between you all, because obviously Kerry, you were in Atomic Kitten for a while, and Kelly, you've done a load of presenting in the past, so you've all sort of experienced what it's like being up there and being yourself in some way, and now you're all actors as well, and actresses.
Mm-hmm.
Do you prefer the acting? Do you prefer being able to hide behind a character?
Yeah, I do. Very much so. Because you can make your mistakes, can't you, and you get a second chance to do it again. So
that's
like
what I said, I prefer it than the presenting thing. No offence, but it was great working with you.
I'll just go. Yeah. Not
no,
finished
it's
yet.
The same because it's live and then you get it all wrong, but you go in there, you can have so much fun and play around and pretend, dress up, and it's like being a kid back at school, isn't it?
Yeah.
You know, just pretend.
Yeah, it's pretend.
It is fun.
I'm having quite a lot of fun just being here presenting with you as well, though. So, sorry you're not enjoying it as much as me, but that's not the end of the world. Thank you very much, both of you, for coming in. I think you're going to stick around
Thanks
for a little
Kelly
bit.
I was supposed to go, but I thought I'd stay.
Well, why not? So, guys, how are you feeling about tomorrow night?
Nervous as ever.
Yeah.
It's getting really hard now. There's not a lot of us left, and it's a hard competition. Everyone's really, really good now. So,
Ben, it's been an amazing sort of roller coaster ride for everybody. And you guys, you were in the final two a few weeks ago, so you know what it's like to have nearly gone. How much do you want this now?
Absolutely, completely. After we were in the bottom two, it really kind of focused our minds in a way that we never thought we were capable of. And we've tried our best even more in every single week ever since and really given our best shot, so hopefully that's come across.
And Mike, from your point of view, I mean, you guys were just four boozy students from the Guild Hall. And boozy students, yeah, believe me, they were. These boys can drink. And then here you are on a primetime TV show singing in front of millions of people. What's the experience been like?
I think it's incredible. I mean, we started out, as you said, and just as a sideline to what we were studying. And we could never have dreamt that we'd get to this stage. And it's just been an amazing experience. We're loving every minute of it. And just to be able to go out each week after getting through and singing on that stage, it's just electric. And we want to stay there till the end.
Because you came down last week, didn't you, Kerry? You were down at the show on The Extra Factor and you saw the boys. What did you make of the whole experience?
It's, you know what, what I had to go through to get an atomic kitten was, you know, compared to what you guys are going through, it's just unbelievable. I feel so sorry for you. But you're fantastic and you're doing really, really well.
It's good fun.
What it's all about. It's fun at the end of the day. It's not the end of the world if you don't win.
And Kelly, have you seen much of X Factor at all?
No, but I will after that performance. Well,
it's amazing that seeing these guys. I think the difference because being in America, they've just got American Idol, which is this huge thing, isn't it? It's massive and
so here, what is it? All age groups can take part.
Exactly. Yeah. We've got groups. We've opened the age groups to everybody. In fact, it's interesting. You're out in the States, so I don't think you've heard much of it. But Jackie, what's the word on the street in America been like about the X Factor? It's going to make compelling viewing, isn't it? Here, Matt, what's been your highlight of the series?
I think it's probably impressionist, the chicken factory.
The chicken man.
Oh, that was hilarious.
From Pickett. who has become, you know, a legend in his own chicken suit, essentially.
Yeah, I think he has.
I would have thought it might have been going to Stringfellows and singing for the Angels.
That's a close second.
It's a close second to the chicken man.
Yeah, yeah.
That was a good part.
And these guys have got some mad fans. In fact, John, your dad showed me this letter last Saturday. John actually had a letter sent to him. John G4 Bogner. And it got to your house, didn't it?
I love that.
It's amazing. Have you been surprised by the support and the fans out there?
Amazing. I don't know, there's so many people on our side and just loving what we do, and that's just incredible. And just like thank them all for keeping us here, because it's down to them now. There's no judges vote, and it's down to the vote, so they need to keep voting
Brilliant.
To keep us here, so please vote.
Well, if you watch The Extra Factor ITV2 at 8:30 tonight, you'll see what the boys are going to be singing. Thank you very much to G4 for coming in. Good luck tomorrow night. I'll see you later on. Kelly, thank you very much. It's lovely to see you. Good luck with the film. Thank you very much to Mini Driver. Of course, to the gorgeous Jackie Brambles, thank you. And last but by no means least, the lovely Kerry Katona.
Yes.
It's lovely to have you with me.
And you.
Enjoyed it.
It's been
lovely.
Absolutely fantastic.
Don't forget, if you want to stay in touch with Issa, you can text showbiz to 81189. There you go, there's the number, 82189. We'll see you next week. Good luck to Nick and Sam for your wedding. Sorry I can't make it.